Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is a TP-Link VIGI NVR. It's the NVR1008H-8MP. It's an 8-channel NVR and PoE switch as well. Not going to be a big technical overview, but we'll show you what you've got in the box. So let's have a little look and then we'll actually talk about the unit a little bit more as well. So that's the unit. We'll have a look at that in a moment. What else have we got here? We have got some conformity guides, your license document, just to mention that it's all legal. Tiny little thing here. I'll just see if I can open it up. Hey, it's one of your conformity guides. We're here in Australia and New Zealand. So that's for here. And you're going to get your quick installation guide as well. Quick thing to say on this, this does support, it has varying names, UID, P2P. Once you've created a TP-Link account and you link this unit to it, it will make a call home to TP-Link's cloud servers, and that allows you to then remotely access it. You can access it locally, but you can access it over the internet, which will mean it can work with what we call carrier-grade NAT. So if you've got a Starlink service or you're putting this on 4G, then you can remotely get access to the unit without having to do any clever port forwarding or have a static or dynamic IP address that actually arrives on your router. You're going to get some little screws and some feet there. Why do you need the screws? Well, we'll talk about that in a moment, but this unit needs a hard drive in it. It does not come with a hard drive. You are going to get a huge power pack. This is probably actually heavier than the unit itself. So we've got our Mickey Mouse input on that side, and we've got our power connector there for you. All right, you are going to get your power lead. We're here in Australia, so there's our Australian power connector there for you. And again, like I said, your Mickey Mouse connector on that side. You are also going to get a mouse. All right, this is a full NVR, so it actually has a video output. And you can connect that directly to a monitor if you want to as well. So just a USB mouse, nothing clever there. You can control this, or you do normally control this using a web browser or the app or your mobile app. But you can also wire this up so you have a simultaneous output. I think you can do four simultaneous video streams at a time. So let's have a little look at the unit itself. Metal construction. Like I said, the first thing you're going to need to do is pair this with a hard drive. I would suggest if you're going to pair it with a hard drive, you do use one that is designed to do surveillance, because it's going to have a lot of read and write to it. So maybe something that, like the Western Digital Purple, or maybe Seagate, I think it is Skyhawk. Those are a good start of drives to have a look at. So we don't have any fans in here. It is side cooled. All right, we do have some options here for rack ears, although they are not that I saw in the box. But you should be able to get, I think, an optional rack mount kit for this. So on the front, we just have our indicators of what's actually happening with our PoE ports on the back. All right, and we now have a USB. We have two USBs on here. You can add external storage. And you can have a mouse and a keyboard connected to this if you want to. Like I said, you've got to put a hard drive in here. Currently, I think it'll support up to a 10 terabyte. You might be able to get larger, but 10 terabyte is the safe side. Right, so on the back, we have our earthing pin over here. We have our QR code to scan. This is for, like I said, our remote access and easy setup. We've got our audio in and out here so that we can do our two-way audio communication if we want there. And then we go to our HDMI out and our VGA out and another USB port. So this could be connected up to directly to a monitor, and you could then set this up as a live console wherever you wanted to be able to see what was going on. Now we have a LAN port, and then we have 8 PoE ports. So this is different to some manufacturers' NVRs. Some manufacturers' NVRs have their and a DHCP service that's going to give a completely separate IP range. This is quite neat. You're going to connect your LAN straight to your normal network. And then you've got 8 PoEs. This is just essentially a PoE switch. So these are going to pick up the IPs from your normal network and pass them on to the cameras. But obviously this allows you to plug in 8 cameras that are all going to receive power. I think the total power is about 113 watts, something like that, so plenty for the cameras. You've got your power in over here as well. It's to note that all of these ports are just 100 meg ports. People get a little bit worried about that, but a camera that even this is going to support an 8 megapixel setup or a 4 megapixel, even that is probably going to be maxing out at sort of 10 or 20 megaseconds, so you don't really need a 100 port connection, 100 megasecond port connection to make that work. So like I said, this is 8-channel. It has the capacity to carry 8 cameras, record all of that simultaneously. The length of time you're going to keep it is going to be based on how long you, how large the hard drive is there. But hopefully that's been fairly useful to actually have a look at. Let me just stretch that round one more time. It's a beautiful little cost-effective NVR. Do head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got loads more box unopenings on wireless network and firewall devices. We've got how-to guides. What do I need to run a TP-Link VIGI surveillance setup? We'll walk you through all the steps of what you need to connect that all together. We've got how-to guides on how to extend your Wi-Fi, how to protect your network with a firewall. So do subscribe and stay up to date.